everybody. It's the coach, and this is Madden 20 on EA Sports. Straight ahead, we've got what should be an interesting matchup between the Los Angeles Rams and the Los Angeles Chargers. With that, let's get out to Dignity Health Sports Park in Southern California as we welcome in our guy, Brandon Godden, and Charles Davis.
All right, Coach, under hazy, overcast LA skies, EA Sports coverage of the NFL brings us to Dignity Health Sports Park in Carson, California. Coming up, we've got what should prove to be a good one between the Los Angeles Rams and their Southern California rivals, the Los Angeles Chargers. Alongside my broadcast partner, Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Godden, and as we look at this matchup, every time there's something different to focus on. So I'll just ask you, what do you see here in this one?
Well, Rembrandt, you've given me a pretty blank canvas to focus on, haven't you?
Yeah.
Where do you think I'm going to go with this?
Oh, secondary?
You know me. You know me well, right? In a game like this, it's always about the secondary. Can they handle the passing attack and make a few plays?
Set now to kick this one away, and off it goes. This fielded a few yards into the end zone, and no run back here. This will be a touchback, and it comes out to the 25-yard line. So out come the Rams now for their first possession. They'll be led out by their quarterback, the guy out of California, the former Cal Bear, Jared Goff.
While in college, quarterback teams had improved their win total from 1 his freshman year, to 5 his sophomore year, to 8 his junior year. Love that type of improvement. Love that type of diligence.
Goff on first down. It's a short one here, complete to the tight end. And he's upended at the 33, following a good pickup of 8. A good pickup there, 8 yards on the first down completion. A good safe pass there right off the bat.
That's almost a rhythm play. That's what we like to call it. Get them into rhythm early, something safe, something they're confident about, something they feel good. And once that's completed, then you just keep moving from there because the confidence elevates.
He'll take this to the other side of midfield before going out of bounds. That one, a gain of 20 and a first down.
And that's a run that'll energize an offensive line. They'll take that one all day long. Fundamental breakdown by the defense. You've got to be able to make plays on the edge.
So on the heels of the run by Todd Gurley, another first and 10. From the gun, here's Goff. Going to Woods, but that pass is intercepted. Picked off by Casey Hayward. 30, 10, and he will score. Touchdown, LA. So a pick six there out of the nickel package. They went with 5 DBs.
Almost becoming the base package in the NFL is the nickel. Hard to throw against. That was demonstrated one more time. A pick six going the other way.
Badgley on for the extra point. And the Chargers grab the 7-0 lead. So the defense creating some points, not only getting the interception, but then returning it to the end zone for the pick six. So they'll get another shot on offense following that pick six, and now the kick is away. This is taken about 7 yards deep. And no run back here. This will be a touchback, and it comes out to the 25-yard line. And now out on the field, here comes Los Angeles. And last time, decent field position through the pick six. Obviously costly.
But they can't afford to just bunker in now. All right, good field position means go ahead and attack on offense. Try and press the advantage a little bit. They just have to be better with the football on this possession.
So the last one, that didn't bother you too much last time?
No, because it's exactly what you're supposed to do. You can't have good field position, not try to take advantage of it. Sometimes the defense makes a good play, too. A quick burst there, and he nicely bit off a pretty decent game.
6 yards on that last play. Here's second and four. Now Goff will hand this one to Gurley. And he'll be brought down shy of the 40 at the 38-yard line. 7 yards there and a first down. And a nice little broken tackle run there by Todd Gurley, the 10th pick in the 2015 draft.
And that's what you get with him, that full package of speed, power, able to catch the ball in the backfield. Many people doubted him coming out because of the knee injury in college. They're seeing the full Todd Gurley now, and it hurts.
An opening there on that first down run as he gets this forward for about 8 or 9. That looks to be 8 officially, so second and 2. You often say that sort of opens the playbook now, second and short. What do you think, early shot here?
I like where you're going. Obviously, we've been together for a while because you know me. I want to take that shot early and loosen things up.
Now on second down, this is Gurley. Only a yard on the pickup, so from a good situation on second and 2, it's now 3rd and 1. The headshots here are the offensive unit, and what about Brandon Cooks?
If he's not a 1,000-yard receiver every year he's healthy in the league, I'll be surprised. Came out of college wanting to be a pro, studied all the best receivers in the NFL before he even got to the league.
Lock 20!
They'll try and pick up the first with Gurley. Now, I don't think Gurley got there. Looks like the defense held him back. Call it no gain there, and it leads to a fourth down. Yes, it's the first half, but we'll see if that stuff there on 3rd and 1 comes back to haunt him.
I hope you don't mind, but it's not going to stop me from putting a check mark next to this play. Let's look back as this game progresses and see if this is one of the key plays in the game, even though it occurred early.
So on fourth down, here's Johnny Hecker to punt it away. And that ball's going to angle out at the 3-yard line. A beauty. They decide against going for it on 4th and 1, maybe to the dismay of their offense, but hey, a nice consolation prize down inside the 5.
Nice consolation prize indeed. So maybe the offense is upset, but they showed confidence in their defense by punting it away.
Here's the Los Angeles offense as they get set to take possession. And they will start this drive with just terrible field position, backed up inside their own 5.
But we have seen teams be bold here and take shots, right? Sometimes you go max protection, make it a one receiver route, and take your shot downfield and see what happens. And occasionally, we've seen success occur. Watching that run takes me back to something a famous old coach once said. Any player he wants on his team, he wants him to be agile, mobile, and most definitely hostile.
I'm coming.
SOS. Play fake to Gordon. Now Rivers. He's got his tight end complete. It's Green. And they'll bring him down here right around the 17-yard line. A gain of 5, good enough for the first down. That's a staple of this offense, drag route to the tight end.
Yeah, he's unable to use his size to break off much more yardage after the catch, but still an effective gain nonetheless.
A first down throw here for Rivers. Complete, Hunter Henry with a grab. 5 yards on the catch there, brings up second down. I think defensively you're okay with that. Here in the first quarter, he's going to get some catches, but they rallied to him quickly.
And that's what you count on, and I like what you just said. First quarter, can you do it all game long? They catch it, you tackle them, they go down on the spot. Because when you're able to do that and you don't give up big chunks of yardage after the catch, now you put the offense in a position where every series, they have to work hard to pick up first downs, and you tend to stall them out when you do that.
Just a couple on the pickup there, and now it's third down.
He's definitely tough to get down. We just saw it right there. But how about what we did see? Pursuit, wrap up, and then the big finish with the tackle.
Third and short yardage, Rivers. And he's got a man open. That's Allen. And he's brought down, getting this one up to about the 35. It's a gain of 11 and a first down, L.A.
Did you see that route the way that I did? I thought he was trying to get deep.
Yeah, that wasn't the first option.
No, not at all. It came off of that guy, the deep guy, and came underneath on the drag, completed it very well.
Ball up to the 35 now as they come up on first and 10. Rivers going to turn and give this one to his running back, Gordon. And this defense not giving him anything there. Maybe a yard up to the 36.
Well, they had that one sniffed out. Excellent run blitz. Stop that one for a short gain.
What makes a good run blitz a good run blitz?
The ability to stay on task, to follow up your assignment, go to the gap you're supposed to cover, and not be deterred by anything else.
On second down, they'll run with Gordon. Two runs in a row, but only 2 yards to show for it.
And this is why aggressive defensive coordinators love to blitz. It wreaks havoc because they end up taking their attention to the blitzers, freed up the D lineman to make the play.
Now play number 7 of this drive, but it's a tough 3rd and 9. On play action, Rivers. Open man, it's Allen. And he'll be taken down, but not before he works it past the 50. 16 yards is the pickup there, and a first down for L.A. I don't think it's a surprise they're throwing the football early. We expected that. They told us they were going to come out firing, but 4 for 4 on the opening drive. They like that.
They don't just like it. They love it because now everyone gets locked in. Your confidence jumps up. Everyone's easy about what they're doing out there. And by the way, they're looking at the sideline thinking to themselves and expressing, let's keep throwing it. We're doing pretty well.
So from Rams territory now, it's 1st and 10 at the 47. From the shotgun, it's Rivers. And that's complete. It's Green here. A gain of 6 there on first. We've seen quite a bit of the short passing game here early on first quarter, haven't we?
We have, and I think it works a couple of ways for this team because, number one, you throw the short game until they stop it. And if they're not going to stop it, you keep throwing it, and occasionally you'll break a tackle and turn into a bigger gain. Also, if they start to creep up, start to pressure receivers, now you go over the top, take it deep, and now you get some of those big shots downfield.
And they went the wrong way there, losing yardage back at the 43-yard line. It'll be a loss of a yard, and they're going to face a 3rd down.
I like the strategy. Extra tight ends, extra beef. They want to run the football, but that means they probably want to run it inside. If you get strung out on the perimeter, you're in peril.
Yeah, we saw the result, negative yardage. The Rams calling on their nickel set here defensively for 3rd down. From the gun, Rivers. He's got a man. It's Williams. And this is going to be another 1st down as the tackle is going to be made at the Rams 30.
I don't believe that this opening drive is surprising to either one of us after the time we spent with the coaching staff and players prior to the game. What about you?
Absolutely. Not only that, but that big article in the paper this morning about their philosophy on starting games like you're shot out of a cannon, and that's what they've done. Very methodical here on this first drive.
Yeah, so many teams talk about that fast start. We're actually seeing it happen right here in front of us.
But now the kicker. Can they cap it off by putting the ball in the end zone? Rivers with a 1st and 10, and he's a perfect 6 for 6 here to start the ball game. Here's the first carry for Austin Eckler. Call it a gain of 4 on first, and that'll make it 2nd down.
I call that play a success. A nice inside run sets up a very manageable 2nd down, a very solid gain on that play.
The run got 4, now they deal with a 2nd and 6.
Check, 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 check. Check, check, check.
And he went nowhere. He'll lose yardage back to the 29. The tally there, minus 2 yards, brings up third down. And never good on a pass completion there to go the wrong way. Lost yardage.
No, for some reason, it seems to work better when you throw it downfield or you can move the ball downfield running it that way, doesn't it? But in this case, if you're the defensive guys, you're energized, executed well, and you caused a lost yardage play. That's going to feel good and look great in film.
They got to get to the 20 to keep the drive alive on third down. Working out of the gun, Rivers. Nowhere to turn here, and he's going to go down. Back at about the 37-yard line. Clay Matthews adding another sack to his impressive NFL resume. And we say it all the time, have to be able to get rid of the ball sooner than that.
You have to help your offensive line out. They're going to protect you as best they can. And if you're getting 3 to 5 seconds to throw the ball, they're doing a really nice job. But when you hold it and give up a sack, you're really almost discrediting their work.
So on fourth down, on comes the Charger kicker, Michael Badgley. This from 54 yards away. And that one's not gonna get there. Not enough juice, an ambitious effort, but it's well short. And this score will stay right where it is.
Charles, 54 yards, I'm surprised that came up short.
I would agree with that one because normally, if he misses, it's accuracy, not length, because he has plenty of leg for that. But maybe it's like I hit my golf shot, you know? Maybe it's like my wedge. You know, when you chili dip and you hit the ground ahead of it, sometimes that'll shorten your distance as well.
So after the missed long field goal attempt, this offense set up nicely at the 44-yard line. They'll start out on the ground with Gurley. And he's going to get across midfield and into Charger territory. 8 yards on the pickup, and now they'll have some options on second and short.
If these kinds of lanes are available, you have to feel like he's going to have a pretty big game on the ground.
Yeah, you can tell early on he's got a little burst in his step, and that's a big pickup right there on first down.
Goff turns and gives to Gurley. And he's corralled, but not before getting it inside the 35. 16 yards is the pickup there and a first down for L.A.
Tremendous blocking by the interior of the offensive line. They didn't just gash him there. They blasted a gaping hole for him to gallop through. And if he comes back to the huddle, he better be giving them a whole lot of credit and thanking them for that much space to rumble.
Back-to-back good plays have him on the move on first down. A shotgun snap for Goff. And the open receiver, it's Robert Woods. 5 yards on the catch there, brings up second down. With that, let's take a look here at the Charger defense.
It's real easy to talk about Thomas Davis coming back from multiple knee injuries, but he wants his play on the field to be the story.
Second and five after the 5-yard completion on first down. Goff gonna hand it to Gurley. And he'll be a couple yards shy of the red zone here at the 22-yard line. 6 yards the pickup, and that's a first down.
Well, they came into this game saying it was important that they set the tone and show that they can run the football. And I believe that they've done that here in the first quarter.
Here goes tonight. 180.
They'll run for the first time here with Brown. And not much to speak of there. Maybe a yard down to the 20.
Watching that play unfold and watching him complete it brought back memories of doing all those pursuit drills to make sure you don't over-pursue and let a guy get a cutback lane on you. He did that very well.
You praised him on tape yesterday for the angles that he takes to the ball. Took a great angle right there.
Now a draw as Goff gives to Gurley.
This will be a 5-yard pickup as they move it from the 20 to the 15. Now after the running play, we've got a man down on the field. We'll step aside and come back to Carson after this. An extra defensive back on the field for the Chargers now on third down. Out of the gun, Goff. Nowhere to escape, and he goes down. Joey Bosa coming in to drop him for a loss of 8, and it also brings up fourth.
Well, it's about how teams are so competitively matched, and you just want to make those plays that give you an advantage. How about right here? The difference between letting them score a touchdown versus holding them to a field goal? That's absolutely huge with the play he just made.
And you know he hated taking the loss there on third down. So on fourth down, here comes Greg Zuerlein to try and get three for the Rams. They'll spot it at the 30, so this is a 40-yard attempt. And Zuerlein's kick is good. And they are on the board, but still trailing. It's 7-3. So three drives now for this offense, and that field goal gives them their first 3 points.
So if you're an offensive coordinator and you're averaging a point a drive, you're in the wrong line of work, aren't you? You got to find a way to unlock the key to these defenses and put some big points on the board.
After the made field goal, Zuerlein back out there now to send this one away. This will be fielded at the 6. And he'll take it past the 25 and up to the 28-yard line. Here we go. Now the Chargers offensive unit ready to see what they can do here. Last time out, they had that long 50-plus yard field goal that they missed.
And I'm sure on their sideline, they're thinking to themselves, okay, do we still want to try one if we're in that position again? And I would dare say that the answer would be yes. They're going to have a lot of confidence in their kicker. But just to be on the safe side, I'm sure they told their offensive guys, can we get a little bit closer this time?
Yeah,
you know, I'd rather get in the end zone first and foremost. But if all else fails, less of a field goal attempt for him. I always laugh when people say, what's the toughest route to defend? And I'm like, any of them, especially if it's a good receiver. That makes things very difficult. But when you're running a drag route, something short, shallow, going through defenders, using guys almost as screens in order to get open, that makes things tougher, guys trying to get to the football.
And he slips up past the 45 before being tackled. That one good for 13 and a Charger first.
And there's a completion to the tight end. And look at the size of these players nowadays. At that spot, 6'4", 6'5", and up. A lot of guys used to be basketball players, somehow came back to football. That's really good for the game of football. You're getting better athleticism, great hand-eye coordination, guys who know how to control their bodies when they run their routes.
And down he goes at the 49, a 3-yard pickup. Michael Brocker's in on the stop.
They tried a quick hitter inside, but that one was swallowed up because what they're hoping, those big defensive linemen will take the bait and move laterally and open up a crease that they can run through. Didn't happen on that play.
On second down, Eckler. And he's going to take this one across midfield and into Ram territory. Give him 3 on the run there. Now they're looking at a 3rd and about 5.
Well, so many times we look at a short run and we praise the offense for trying to set the tempo and establish things, but the defensive guys, hey, they just won the battle there. It wasn't a big run given up. They don't always have to absorb the body blows. Sometimes they dish them out themselves.
To throw is Rivers. He's got his man. It's Williams. And this is going to be another first down as the tackle's going to be made at the Rams' 27-yard line. Rivers with a first and 10. And he's hit on his first 9 passes now in the ball game. Now Rivers. And they will not get the connection there. It's incomplete.
Everything about that play tells you about today's NFL offenses and what they're asking out of running backs. You can't just be a guy who can run the football. You have to be able to catch it as well. And he didn't get that done on that play.
Rivers incomplete on first down. Here's second and 10. To throw again. Rivers. It's Williams on the catch. And finally, down he goes as they work it inside the 10 to the 7. Third catch for him on this drive alone, and it'll give him a first down. To Eckler, and they'll be driven back here, losing yardage to the 10-yard line. A loss of a full 3 yards, and now it's second down. Well, they try to swing it out left into the flat, complete, but really nice open field tackling.
And they played that one like a great boxer. They were on their toes on that one. They weren't back on their heels reacting to the play. No, they saw it, came right for it, and made a nice tackle for lost yardage.
Moved back to the 10. They'll try on second and goal here. Now Rivers going to give it off to Gordon. And he takes it in for a Charger touchdown. A 10-yard touchdown run. The Chargers, they're able to widen their lead. And they're able to run it in. It started with a battle in the trenches. They won there, and they got in for 6 points.
And that's going to be a tough one for the defense to deal with. They've got to go to the bench now and figure out how we're going to slow down this running game, because on that particular play, they had no answer.
Badgley on for the extra point. And this one's right through to make it a 14-3 ball game. A good drive that time as they go 9 plays in all. And it's capped off by a touchdown run coming from Melvin Gordon. The kickoff team on the field now as they will send this one away. This will be fielded at the 8. And he'll take this one near the 25, call it the 26-yard line. Todd Gurley in the Rams offense set to take over. And I'm wondering if maybe they don't go away from him on this drive a little bit. He's been great, but they haven't scored a lot of points.
Think they still have to show him as a threat, make sure he touches it a few times, but as you pointed out, use him as a decoy a little bit and get the ball in the hands of some other people in order to put more points on the board. But he's done a really nice job of establishing them with his running.
Yeah, he's established himself well. Now can they put more points up?
They'd love to just strike back with a touchdown right here, and if it's a long play, so be it. But the main goal, get a couple of first downs, run some plays, run some clock, allow their defense to get a chance to catch their breath, settle down, and relax a little bit after they just gave up a score.
Throwing on second and 3. Goff, nowhere to escape, and he goes down. Joey Bosa able to get in there for his second sack of the afternoon.
Sometimes I watch games and wonder why they use play fakes on certain passing situations, because it's not going to fool anyone. I don't know if that was the case here, but the end result was the same. No one fooled. The quarterback was hit.
So Goff, he'll try to refocus after the sack. The Rams now set up with a tough one, a third and long. Now it's gone. Under pressure again, and down he goes again. Joey Bosa getting him once again, his third sack of the afternoon.
I'm starting to feel for that quarterback back there. I mean, you know me. Normally, don't have a lot of empathy for the QB, right? In this case, definitely. He's been on constant duress this entire game. I don't know how he's surviving back there.
And to think, there's still a long way to go in this football game. Here's Johnny Hecker now, as he'll punt it away for the second time. And this is away. It's a high kick, and he got all of it. This is taken at the 18. That one in the books as a 64-yard punt. And it'll be Charger football here as they take over. The Chargers getting set to go. And that last drive, a long drive, but not just that. They had a great air attack going. Do they stick with that?
I would think that they would, because if they were confident enough to do it on the last drive, starting backed up in their own territory, why would you change anything? They've got to be confident about what they're presenting and continue to do so.
Yeah, because the secondary, they really look clueless.
And that was amazing, because that drive went and went, no adjustments and no big plays by the defense to knock the ball away.
Here's second and nine, just a yard on that last run. And he's going to lose yardage and be backed up to the 25. It's a loss of two, now third down.
If you're a selfish player and you're throwing the ball, you're cool with the completion. Maybe not so cool with the yardage loss, though, huh?
Yeah, you went backwards on the yardage. Hey, it kind of works like a sack for the defense there.
Yeah, it's a really big play for them, right? Able to figure it out, sniff it out, and finish it off.
The Chargers on third down. They've been near perfect. 4 for 5 to this point. This is third and 11. Operating from the gun, Rivers. And it's complete. Henry, give him 15 yards on that one. And a Charger first down.
Like so many tight ends nowadays, they have no problem at all putting him in the slot and letting him go to work. And that's a nice pitch and catch right there for a first down.
So from the 39 now, they'll come up on a first and 10. They run it here with Gordon. And he still has yet to get on track in this first half as they're going to stop him behind the line. It's a loss of two there, bringing up second down.
He did have the touchdown run earlier, but not a heck of a lot more than that throughout this game.
No, not at all. In fact, I would say that this defense has done as good of a job on him as they have on any runner in recent memory. Play action now, Rivers. And that gonna be incomplete. A lot of contact, no call, and it's third down. Those passes out that far wide always make you hold your breath a little bit. Felt like it was in the air for a while.
What it does is allows a defender to gain some ground, come from a long distance, and have a chance to affect the pass.
An incomplete pass on that last play, and that means he'll need to come up with something here on third down. Throwing, Rivers. And nowhere to
get away. Rivers is dropped. Clay Matthews picks up his second sack of the afternoon. And, partner, it's safe to say that the secondary really contributed to that sack.
Yeah, nickel set, five defensive backs. They covered everything, nowhere to go with the football. But my question is, why didn't he throw it away?
Fourth down and on is Ty Long to punt. JoJo Natson back deep for the Rams. We'll call that a 49-yard punt with a return of just two. And the Rams will go on offense here with a first and 10. And our attention shifts to Todd Gurley. He's been good. They've utilized him well, but they're losing here in the second quarter. What might they change offensively?
I think that what you try and do is expand how you get the ball to him a little bit. Get him out in open space, maybe swing the ball to him. What's that they used to call in the West Coast offense, the long handoff? Yeah. Serve as your running play that way, as well as continue to feed him the football. Some of these runs now may pop bigger later in the game, because of the effects of running it. Sometimes people, after a while, they don't want to tackle him anymore, or they get tired, or they get out of position, or he runs through tackles. Continue to feed him the ball. He's having that kind of game.
Yeah, might they get him the ball in some space in some different ways here. So from the 36 now, first and 10. Goff now looking to throw. Going up top for Kupp. Well, this is taken in. It's complete. He got 29 yards that time. This offense finding its legs now. Here's another first and 10. Now it's Gurley. 2 yards on the pickup there. It'll be second and 8.
Let's give a lot of credit to the offensive line. They've been able to move the ball really well on the ground the entire game. And while that wasn't a huge one, that's okay. They'll take them in short, steady bursts.
Here's Gurley. Down to the 30 after a gain of 3.
Brandon, all things considered, they have to feel pretty good about getting that type of a gain considering the blitz that they just had against them.
The Rams on third down, 0 for 3 to this point. They could use a conversion. This will be third and 5. Here's Goff. Pressure, and he will go down. Sacked back at the 38. Jerry Tillery in there to drop him for a 6-yard loss, and that will lead to fourth down.
The amount of sacks that they've absorbed in this game is absolutely extraordinary. Let's just face it. This offensive line, flat out, cannot handle this pass rush. It's been demonstrated time and time again.
So out comes the field goal team now for the second time here today. And quite a bit of pizza in this box. It's a 53-yard attempt. And this one looks good. It is good. Right down the pipe. And a second field goal here cuts their deficit to 14-6 now. These kickers now, it's like we take them for granted. Kicks like that used to be such a big deal, and now you just expect them to make it.
Yeah, you're exactly right, and we shouldn't take them for granted. But I have a theory about it. You want to hear it?
Yep.
They are more athletic now than ever before. Talk about kickers. Trace their backgrounds, trace their histories. You'll find that they were big-time athletes all along, but their kicking was so prevalent that we made them specialists.
Well, and now those 50-plus yarders seem easy for some reason.
after the made field goal. Zuerlein back out there now to send this one away. This is taken about 7 yards deep. And no run back here. This will be a touchback, and it comes out to the 25-yard line. Here comes the Chargers offense now back out onto the field. They're out in front. Last time they had to punt it away. We'll see if they can add to their lead now.
They don't want to go out and punt it away again. This team now wants to get a cushion, put people away. They want to run their offense and have it end up in the end zone.
A throw on the quick slant, going to be complete. 10 yards on the pickup there, and it'll be second down.
Slant route's effective no matter who's running the route and catching the ball. But when you have a receiver of that stature, you have to be a little bit more precise throwing it. You don't have the same catch radius with the bigger targets.
Still a few inches short of a first down as they come up now on second down. They go play action. Rivers. And caught by Henry. Give him 12 yards there, and the Chargers have a first down.
There are so many things to watch for when you play defense, and reading your keys, you always hear about that, and having your eyes in the right place. Sometimes your eyes can fool you. How about that play action there? And it sprang the big guy, didn't it?
Able to dump it over the top to him. Back-to-back good plays have him on the move on first down. Gordon. And he's going to take this one across midfield and into Ram territory. It's a 7-yard carry to set them up with a second and three.
So if you've been playing defense in this one, there's a little bit of the good and some bad, because they did give up the touchdown run to him earlier but shut him down otherwise.
Outside of that, you're exactly right. I would say they've contained him very well.
Let's go. You tighten up. Slam.
Rivers, he leaves to Eckler on the draw, and he'll get it down here to the 43. They'll get three as the drive continues. It's a first down.
It's nice every now and then in this game not to see people overthink it. Just hand it to the old reliable guy, let him pick up the first down.
The white 90, flash 15!
Rep.
White 89!
Play fake to Gordon, now Rivers. It's complete to Williams. They'll get this one down near the 20-yard line, just shy of the 20. A well-executed 22-yard gain. A nice little completion there by Phillip Rivers. And you and I were reading the article yesterday. Fifth grade, Rivers had to do a project where he had to make a poster about his dreams and aspirations. So he clipped out a football player from a magazine article and pasted his face on the helmet. That's what he wanted to be, and it turned out okay.
Not so bad, not so bad at all. Remember, he's the son of a coach. And on that play, I think he made the old coach proud with that completion.
Now Gordon on first down. And he is swallowed up right at the line of scrimmage. No gain on the play there, second down. And he got off the end there very quickly to make that play.
Yeah, it was almost like the bullet train, wasn't it? I mean, just zoom, quick. And what a terrific play, holding them to no gain.
Now it's a bootleg with Rivers. Toward the right sideline, but it's incomplete. He was looking for Travis Benjamin that time. But now it's third down.
Had the right idea there, trying to throw it to the sideline, but he led him just a little bit too much, trying to get it out to his receiver. Ends up falling to the ground, incomplete.
The Chargers on third down. They've been very good, 5 for 7 thus far. This is third and 10. Now Rivers. And this is complete. It's Allen. And he takes it in for a Charger touchdown from 21 yards away. And the Chargers, they're able to widen their lead.
All drives that result in points hurt a defense, but when they are the sustained variety, play after play, and they just can't get off the field and stop them, that can be demoralizing.
Here's Badgley now to try to add the PAT. It's up and good, and that'll make the score 21-6. So that one, an eight-play drive. It spans 75 yards, and it winds up with a touchdown for Los Angeles. The kickoff unit as they run up and send this one away. This is taken at the three. And he'll bring it a few past the 20 to the 23-yard line. The Rams offense now, they get set and head back onto the field. And fortunate to get points on the board last time. They had to hit a really long field goal to do so.
The kickers in today's game are so good and so skilled and hit from distances that we almost start to take them for granted. And we can't do that. That's a long field goal that they got 3 points out of. They've got to feel good about that, and they better make sure they love him up.
The Chargers able to get the pressure and bring him down. Joey Bosa, who else? He's in there for his fourth sack of the afternoon.
Well, someone's been up to the task so far in this game. They are already up a couple of scores, Brandon, and guess what? I think they're just going to pin their ears back now and get upfield and get after the quarterback.
Been such an impressive first half to get that lead. Sacks a growing theme in this first half. This is second and long. 2 minutes remaining in this first half of football. Coming up at halftime, we'll pay a visit to Jonathan Coachman. He's in Orlando, and he'll have our EA Sports halftime report. Now a quick slant as the throw's complete. And he fumbled it. It's on the ground. And picked up by the Chargers. And they will set up shop with outstanding field position in the red zone at the 17-yard line. Well, he did what he's known for. He made the catch, then he turned into a runner, took the contact, and coughed it up.
And all I remember as a player, when they catch the ball, when those acrobatic guys catch it, you have to make them pay sometimes. You have to put it on them, big tackle, knock the ball free. Anything you can do to slow them down.
Getting set to go again here on offense, Keenan Allen marches back onto the field. He's doing what he's capable of, having a solid game. Not the most amazing game. He's not over 100 yards, but a good game so far.
And you just know that mentally, he feels like he's one catch away from turning it into a great game and starting on that road. And the defenders are well aware of that, too. They've got to figure out a way to not let that escalate. Keep him right in this zone here and call it a day, because otherwise, he can really decimate them.
Better believe they are well aware of his playmaking ability. And with that completion, he's now north of 200 yards here in the first half. Boy, a tough start for the secondary defensively.
It is, and it's got to put a dent in their confidence. And, you know, you always want to keep that up and feel like you can always bounce back after plays. But with the kind of numbers he's putting up here, it's starting to wear on them a little bit, I think. So they're looking at each other and trying to figure out what defense will work and how can they play better without getting beat deep.
And he's going to go down. Sacked back at the 13-yard line. Clay Matthews able to disrupt yet another pass play. That is his third sack of the afternoon.
Well, that was point counterpoint, wasn't it? They decide to throw for it on first and goal. Instead, the defense counters with pressure, and the defense wins, getting a big sack.
So first down went in the wrong direction. They're at the 13-yard line. Here's second and goal. Throwing Rivers. Looking for his running back, and he's got him. Now the Chargers going to signal for the first of their timeouts as they'll stop it with a tick under a minute to go before half. In their mind, certainly a field goal try would be a letdown. They had the great starting field position. Now facing third down. From the gun, Rivers. He's going to hit his man out of the backfield. Complete. The Rams going to go ahead and use the first of their timeouts as they get the stoppage with a little over 50 seconds to go in the first half. So out comes the field goal team now for the second time here today. From the left hash, a chip shot here. Badgley's kick is good. And that will extend their lead even further. So he gets a shot at atoning for the earlier miss here in the first half and able to knock it through.
And what a relief for him, don't you think? Because how many games have we done where kickers missed one early and never gotten a chance to atone for it the rest of the game? That's a lot to carry around.
The kickoff unit is out on the field, and they will send this one away. This is fielded at the chalk of the 10. And he'll take this across the 25, a couple extra yards, up to the 27-yard line. Todd Gurley and the offense, they get set and trot back out there now. And Charles, you can't really fault him. He's over 100 yards already. He's not the reason they're losing.
And that is really unusual because ordinarily when you've set the tone this way and have run it this effectively, usually your team's in control. So it's a very strange situation. And you're right, you can't fault him. He's done a great job for his team thus far.
I'm guessing he's saying, feed me on the sidelines. Now will they continue to do it?
And partner, I think that was a great example that not all tight ends are created equal, because everything was right, got the completion, but he's not one of the more dynamic guys in the league. So even though he caught it, couldn't turn it into much more.
That first down completion only netted him 3. Second and 7. Now gone. And his throw is incomplete. Brandon Cooks, the receiver he was going after. Third down here.
It's been my observation, there's been a nice variety of play calling defensively. You and I often talk about an offense's ability to keep a defense off balance with what they're doing. I think the converse has been true in this game.
Yeah, I think you're right. They seem to have gone off tendency quite a bit, but only the second quarter, a lot of time to change things. Now gone. And this is going to be incomplete.
Sometimes it's just not your day. There's another failure right there on third down.
Here's Johnny Hacker now as he's on to punt for L.A. He's been a busy man here in this first half as he gets it away. And that'll hit at the 5 and go into the end zone for a touchback. Phillip Rivers and his Chargers about ready to take over again. He's played a pretty clean first half, a touchdown, no interceptions.
Frankly, that's what they expect out of it. They want to see the ball thrown and thrown well, and he's able to do that and put it in the end zone. They'd love to see more of that before this game finishes. But right now, he's got his team in a good spot.
A good spot, maybe looking for touchdown pass number 2 here in the second quarter. And he'll just push his way forward for a few as the clock will run.
Brings up 2nd and 9 at the 21-yard line.
2nd and 9 now from the 21.
I'm going to run you over.
They'll keep it on the ground again here. And he's upended after a gain of 4 up to the 25-yard line. So we reach halftime in what's been a fairly one-sided game so far. As we send you to Orlando to check in with Jonathan Coachman at our EA Sports Halftime Report. Coach?
Okay, right, Brandon. Thanks very much. And welcome in, everyone, to this slimmed-down version of the EA Sports Halftime Report. This one is maybe not exactly in the bag yet, but there is definitely a big mountain to climb in this third quarter. The teams are already back out there, so let's not waste any time as we'll turn it back over to Brandon Godden.
All right, Coach, thank you, and we welcome everyone back for quarter number three. So the Chargers will start the second half with the lead and the football as we're underway in the third quarter. This is taken about 7 yards deep. And no run back here. This will be a touchback, and it comes out to the 25-yard line. Out comes the Chargers as they'll go on offense now to start this third quarter. They built a good first-half lead. Now they have a chance to add on to it.
And what I'm thinking is that the offensive staff spent the entire halftime just working with them on, here's what we think they're going to do to attack us in the second half. Nice first half that we've had, guys, but be prepared for some change-ups. We're going to see them when we kick it off in the second half.
See how they handle any adjustments that might be made defensively.
And plays like that are exactly what this defense needs here early in the second half to give it a little spark. I think their halftime adjustments, what they talked about, maybe it was just a little inspirational speech. Who knows? But looks like they're ready to go.
A loss of a yard there to start out. That leads to a second and 11. Rivers hands off to Eckler. After getting stuffed on first down, not much better there. 2 yard gain.
Sometimes you're aligned perfectly and the play comes to you, and sometimes you got to cover some ground to go make the play, as we just saw there.
We saw a great example of perseverance right there on that play.
Got to be careful. They might want to throw one over his head as this game progresses.
Play fake. Rivers. Open man, it's Allen. And they work this well upfield across the 45. 68 yards receiving now for him in the game. And a first down on that last catch as well. He's such a good route runner. Shows it there on third down. Very proficient and a good pass.
And you know what I've observed over the years in the NFL? The better a route runner you are, the more confidence your guy's going to have in you to go to you in important times, because he can trust you being in the right spot. And they connected there and picked up a first down.
Tweet that. 180.
Tight end right. Hey, we are.
Draw play. It's Eckler. And they're well past midfield, just a yard or two shy of the 40. That one good for 13 and a Charger first. What makes a draw play like that successful?
Well, we did see where he made the first wave miss, and that was a big part of it. But a lot of it is just being actors back there, making the defense think it's going to be a pass.
So from Rams territory now, it's first and 10 at the 41. From the gun, Rivers. That's complete to Williams out of the backfield. 7 yards, the pickup on the pitch and catch.
Many teams, as soon as they spot man defense, if they haven't called a hitch, they'll get to it as fast as they can. They want to put the ball in the hands of one of their best playmakers and hope that he can break a tackle on the outside and go for big yardage.
Able to get 7 on that first down pass play. Second and 3. And this is going to be incomplete. Allen, the intended receiver, and it's 3rd and short.
I know our vantage point might be a little bit better way up here, but that looked like an ill-advised throw to me. I didn't see anything open, and this play just didn't look right from the beginning.
It did not. I thought he might get outside and just chuck it away. Dangerous pass, incomplete. So the incomplete pass on the last play, and that leads us to a third and three. On play action, Rivers. And he's got a man open. That's Allen. And this is going to be another first down as the tackle's going to be made at the Rams' 17-yard line. Whatever the discussions were at halftime to try to slow down this offense, it has not worked to this point.
Yeah, I have a vision right now of everything that was discussed at the half just being torn in shreds or being erased off of the Microsoft Surface tablets because none of it is working. They are really locked in on offense.
From the red zone now, Rivers. And that's going to be incomplete. Too tough to hold on to that one. It's second down.
Once you get into the red zone and the safeties have less ground to cover, you better be quick with your delivery. Not much space to get a ball in there.
Yeah, when that field shrinks with those safeties, it's almost like there's a couple extra defenders out there, right?
It certainly is. They end up taking up extra space just because there's not enough space for receivers to run through.
On second down now. It's Gordon, and this time he's going backwards. So after the no gain on the last attempt, here they get him behind the line.
He continues to struggle to find a crease to break off a big one and might need to just put that aside and just try and ram his way forward and get what he can.
The Rams go nickel here defensively on third. From the shotgun, it's Rivers. Complete. It's Henry. And the tackle made at the 13. He is well short of the first. Just a five-yard pickup, but it leads to fourth down.
Whether you're playing West Coast offense or not, one of the maxims of the West Coast offense is you're either throwing a touchdown or a check down. In other words, look for the big shot, but be smart. And I think they did exactly that on that play. They didn't get the first down, but they're taking care of the ball well.
Yeah, and being rightly cautious with that lead here in the second half. Here's Michael Badgley now for the Chargers field goal.
A 30-yard attempt.
Badgley able to punch this one through. And that will extend their lead even further. So put another three on the board. All things considered, a good opening drive to begin the third quarter.
And as a defense, the way that this game is going, you're excited to see those points go on the board. Gives them a little bit of leeway to play with when they're out on the field, but they're real excited to see their offense score. Now they get to go out there and do their part.
Set now to kick this one away, and off it goes. This will be fielded at the 8. And a nice return sets him up pretty good here at the 30-yard line. Out come the Rams. They'll have it first here to begin the third quarter. They trail offense, first time to touch the ball in quarter three, and we'll see what they can do.
And I can't wait to see what they have planned because some teams script to start a half. Other teams just go, okay, these are the sequence of plays we want to run. These things worked well for us. And sometimes they throw in that big chunk play right away.
Shocker.
Try and get after them early and try and create a big play to give themselves some momentum.
See what they have up their sleeve. It'll be a first down for the Rams there on a pickup of 18. Well, that tight end position, it just seems to continue to evolve every year in the NFL.
Yeah, you're getting really terrific athletes. A lot of them maybe were wide receivers at one point. They continue to give you speed, great hands, and big bodies, which make them excellent targets for quarterbacks.
A big hitter to start the drive has him up near midfield here for first and 10. A shotgun snap for Goff. That's going to be knocked away and incomplete. He was in search of his tight end, Tyler Higbee, and it's second down.
This defense is continuing to contest every deep ball that is thrown downfield. And look, it doesn't matter whether you're playing man or zone. Eventually, that becomes man on man, and you've got to trust yourself and go up in that moment of truth and make a play on the football.
They run out of the shotgun with Gurley. And he's going to get across midfield and into Charger territory.
And there's a run to be happy with. Good, solid yardage. You'll take that anytime you hand the ball to a back.
This offense in desperate need of a conversion as they come up on third down. From the gun, here's Goff. And that is incomplete.
Let's face it, if you want to get back into the game, these are the kind of throws you've got to hit. He's wide open right there. Got to be able to get it to him, don't you think?
And those are the throws that haven't been available to them every time he's dropped a pass. Yeah, that's a big miss. Here's Johnny Hecker now. He's been one of their few bright spots so far. And now where will the side judge stop his walk? That's the question. He says it crossed out of bounds at about the 17-yard line. And we spotlight Keenan Allen as he gets set to go back to work. Pretty good game for him so far. I guess he's still got time here to make this a great game, but so far, he's been solid.
I like where you're going with that because it has been pretty good, but there's always that hint that things can really escalate for him. And right now, they feel like they're somewhat keeping him in check, but he has found the end zone once. But boy, he can explode at any moment.
Yeah, and when you hit that end zone once, you want to find it again, don't you?
Yes, you do.
You get hungrier.
You get greedy in a good way. As usual, the hallmark of a good run defense, linebackers making plays near the line of scrimmage. Absolutely nowhere to run there.
Hey, Brown 80.
You got Allen hit. He lost the football. And now the Rams have got it. Going the other way. And they are going to score on the fumble return. Touchdown, L.A. So hold the phone here, Charles. I've kind of written them off, but after that touchdown, certainly a long way still to go, but stranger things have happened.
Well, when you're going to have big second-half comebacks, plays like that have to be involved.
Now Greg Zuerlein on for the extra point. And he's got it to make it 27-13. So not only the cough up, but then the pickup on the other side, the scoop, and the score the other way, the fumble return for a touchdown. And you can bet they're preaching two hands on the ball here as the kick's away following that fumble return. This will be fielded on the back line of the end zone. And no run back here. This will be a touchback, and it comes out to the 25-yard line. Phillip Rivers now gears up to take the offense back out there. How do you break down his game so far? Just the one touchdown pass, but sometimes the touchdown pass stat category, that doesn't tell the whole story.
It really doesn't. Not until you balance it with the error side, you know? And in this case, he hasn't thrown any interceptions. So a lot of people would call this almost a pedestrian game, kind of a bus driver game. But that's just really wrong. Being a bus driver is a good thing if you're running a football team, because that means you're in control and you're taking your team to the right places.
Yeah, he's been pretty solid.
Part of the thinking when you bring in extra tight ends, you're hoping that each of your guys gets those one-on-one blocks and creates a crease for your runner. You know what the converse is, though? You've got to win those one-on-one blocks. And when you don't, that's the result you end up with.
First play of the drive goes the wrong way. Here's second and 12.
It's just me and you.
They'll run out of the gun with Eckler. And this one goes nowhere. Losing yardage back at the 22. That'll be a loss of a yard, and it leads to a third down. Now, they struggled to get him rolling on the ground in the first half, and that's sort of continuing here in the third quarter.
Yeah, but I don't think it's time to abandon the running game. I would say keep feeding the horse, and I believe he'll eventually reward them, especially as we get deeper in the game.
So time to start going in the other direction as they come up now, third and long. Off the play fake here, Rivers. And the throw there going to be incomplete.
When you see passes knocked down by those guys I call the frustrated fullbacks, the linebackers, you know that in their zone coverage, they were able to drop, see the ball thrown, and react to it very quickly.
Here's Ty Long now, as he'll kick it away for the second time. Here's Natson, dancing away at the 30. Good coverage there, an even 50-yard punt leads to a return of 5. And possession will switch hands, first and 10. And the Rams now coming out on the field. And down on the scoreboard, certainly needing to avoid what happened on the last drive, punting the football.
Sense of urgency has to take over for them here. They know the score. They know the situation. And by the way, the punter no longer exists for their offense. That's how they have to treat this drive.
They need points.
Big time.
Tackle made there by the safety, Derwin James.
When we see those runs to the perimeter, when we see those runs to the edge, we think about big breakers, don't we? In this case, it was a modest gain, but it does open up possibilities here on second down.
3 yards on that last carry. Here's second and 7. On the draw, Goff gives to Gurley. And the second wave of tacklers is going to get him as they stop him behind the line. That's a big loss of 3, and it brings up third down.
But these guys are going to chop into that deficit. They got to do a much better job in the run game. Caught behind the line of scrimmage, no yardage would be found.
These guys have punted 4 times already, and they're staring at a 5th, barring a conversion here on third down. To throw is gone. Nowhere to escape, and he goes down. Jerry Tillery able to get in there for his 2nd sack of the afternoon.
Well, the beauty of screen passes is they take a little time to develop, and they can often hit big, but sometimes they take too long to develop, and sometimes you get sacked.
Yeah, what's perfectly called for a defense to attack a screen?
Typically a blitz, and even though people think that the screen operates against the blitz, if you have the blitz called and you still cover the screen, now that allows your blitzers to get there.
Here's Johnny Hecker now, as the drive goes backwards, so he's on to punt it away. And he deserves a bronze leg as he gets this one away. And no one there to stop it. Hits at the 8, but it carries all the way into the end zone for a touchback. Phillip Rivers now gears up to lead the offense on the field. And right now, probably just one thing in his mind, it's getting back to the hot start because he's really faded.
And ordinarily when that happens, the quarterback, as you know, is usually the leader of the squad. Now,
nowhere to escape, and he goes down. The perennial Pro Bowler Aaron Donald gets the sack.
And that was just absolute perfect man coverage. Nowhere for them to go with the football led to a sack. And that's really difficult to do in today's NFL with all these gazelles running around that you're trying to cover in the secondary.
Don't need it all back at once, but you figure they're going to need something here. 17 yards to go on second down. They'll give it to Gordon out of the shotgun. Yeah, he is met quickly in the backfield. Down he goes, folded like a lawn chair.
Sometimes with the running game, you've just got to stick with it. Look, it's the third quarter, no time to panic. But that also doesn't mean you just do it the same way you've been doing it the entire ball game. Maybe change up some blocking assignments or run a few different plays, but stay with the overall essence of the running game.
20 step round 80. Set 180.
Off play action, Rivers, he's airing it out for Williams, and that'll wind up incomplete. Bold play call there. Now it's fourth down.
I remember a coach told me a long time ago the difference between playing corner and safety in the NFL. Corner is like the Autobahn. Everybody just flying by, and these corners have been really busy in this game, although they got it done on the last play.
On the last play, yes, but there have been some good numbers put up against them offensively. Here's Ty Long now, as he's on to punt for L.A. Averaging over 50 yards a punt so far as this one's away. 51 yards on the punt there. And that will come the offense as they take over. Now the Rams offense, they work their way back on the field.
Now, if you're a fan of punting, and I know that not many people are, but this game kind of turning into one for you.
Well, it's okay if it's a skills contest, right? We're really into it then, but not during the course of an actual game. This has turned into a field position game, though. Sometimes a better punter may actually determine the outcome.
A little bit of daylight on that first down run sets him up nicely. 8 yards on the carry. A good run there on first down, and it'll leave him with a second and two.
First play of the drive, let's give credit all around. Excellent blocking, but the guy carrying the ball, he was the finisher. A really nice run.
We got heavy. Everybody scoot up. Heavy.
Now it's Goff off the bootleg. He's going to dump it off to Gurley. And they go backwards here, losing yardage back at the 48-yard line. It'll be a loss of one, and all of a sudden here, it's third down.
That was well defended, and while it was a completion, it resulted in a loss of yardage. It's really, really hard for a running back to think to himself, I probably should have just dropped it and saved the yardage. It goes against the entire training that he's had his whole career.
These guys have punted four times already, and they're staring at a fifth, barring a conversion here on third down. Back to the workhorse today. It's Gurley. And he gets it down to the 48, enough for the first. They have the first down with that gain of 4 yards.
Well, someone's been having a good game so far, and you know something? Lava has been power running. They decided to turn him loose again on third down, didn't they?
They did indeed. He delivered the tough yards. With Gurley. Now Goff. And that'll wind up incomplete. Trying to give his man room to run under it, but it's second down. They have not gotten him going at all. Tried to spark something there with a longer throw, unable to complete it.
But you have to keep trying. He's one of their best playmakers. No matter what it says on the scoreboard, you're always trying to get him the football.
After the incomplete pass, here now is second and 10. Here comes a 20th carry for Gurley. And he'll be taken down at the 44-yard line.
That second down play call was not to pick up the first down. It was to accomplish what they did to get him into a manageable third down because they had incompletion on first down, so they were behind the sticks, so to speak. They needed to make up some ground, and they did.
This offense in desperate need of a conversion as they come up on third down. Out of the gun, gone. And he's going to be swallowed up. sacked back at the 45-yard line. Joey Bosa, my goodness, make that now five sacks for him in this ball game. Really, really turning in an incredible performance.
This offensive line flat out cannot handle this pass rush. We've seen it demonstrated time and time again to the tune of seven sacks in this game thus far.
Here's Johnny Hecker now. He's been terrific so far. He steps into this one, and this is a rocket. And this is going to be ruled out, I think, just inside the 20. Yes, it will. Side judge calls it at the 19-yard line. Getting set to go again here on offense, Keenan Allen marches back onto the field. Sort of a slow and steady game so far, but reliable for him here in this third quarter.
Sounds like we're describing a possession receiver, right? The one that finds a way to make the big catches, the ones that break the backs of defenses, keep first downs accumulating. I think he's that and maybe a little bit more.
Yeah, he's been pretty good so far. We'll see if he can make this good game a great game. Officially, no gain on the play, and it's second down. If this defense wants to stay in this ballgame, they've got to start ending some drives. That helps.
And they have to look ahead at what they expect the offense to do. And right now with that lead, that's run the football. So you don't just stack the line of scrimmage. You have to get upfield and try and make some plays in their backfield.
Throwing on second down, Rivers. He's got his tight end complete. It's Green. And that play goes nowhere. He's met behind the line, and a penalty flag may add insult to injury. Well, your QB's been sacked four times in the game already, and they're the holding call.
And you know darn well the offensive line coach is frustrated and upset that he's been hit that many times already. He doesn't really care that they hold now. Just don't let him get hit anymore.
And he'll be about a full yard shy of the 20 at the 19-yard line. Without the previous penalty, that would have been a first down. Instead, it's just a gain of 10.
Set, 380.
It's going to be a long day, offense. It's going to be a long day.
On third down, Rivers. He's got a man. It's Williams. And they work this well upfield across the 45. That's good for 28 yards. So on that play, defense was in the zone. They ran a crossing route offensively, but the defense there, you got to be good with communication, don't you?
You certainly do, and it's not something that is really evident when you watch it on the screen. But everyone's talking, communicating, pointing, and it keeps you from chasing receivers because you have a specific zone you have to cover. When a receiver's in your zone and he crosses to another one, you got to let your guy know. They got a completion there, but I like the discipline they show to stay in their proper areas and then make the tackle.
Running on first down, Eckler. And he's going to take this one across midfield and into Ram territory. The longtime Charger, Eric Weddle, makes a stop against his former mates.
Third quarter and you've got the lead. You're not ready to go into that four-minute offense to close the game out, but a running game can really benefit your team right now.
Trying to get one more in here before the quarter breaks. Play action now, Rivers. Benjamin's got it. And he'll be brought down on what's going to turn out to be the final play of this third quarter. Three quarters in the books. This is the National Football League on EA Sports. Another tote for Gordon. He's been busy this afternoon and only able to muster a couple down to about the 27. Offensively with the lead, you want to run the ball, keep the clock going, but you also want to still kind of be in attack mode too, right? So how do you do that and not come back on your heels?
Yeah, think about all the practices we've watched where they have that tempo period to go over things just like this, where they describe the scenario, tell you what they're looking for, and make sure that they're still attacking, yet at the same time not going so fast as to leave too much time on the clock.
A 10-yard pickup, and it's enough for a Charger first down.
Another nice pickup through the air, and I think a lot of people might expect them to run the ball in this situation, Brandon, but with this lead, they're electing to throw the football. Swings, slants, quick outs, things that they consider safe.
Inside the red zone here. They'll look to throw. And that's complete. It's Green here. And he'll take it down here just shy of the 15 at the 16-yard line. A minimal gain there on the eighth play of the drive.
Well, they were unable to make anything really big out of that, but it's not a bad idea to find your tight end and give him an easy completion and keep moving things forward. Almost as bread and butter, it's a good running back dive play.
To throw again on second down. Rivers complete. Hunter Henry with a grab. He's down inside the 10 to the 8. And it comes on a gain of 8. 8 yards on the completion, but now they face third down.
Let's not quibble about the gain there on second down. That was a positive play because that was a take what you can get situation. Got out to the tight end. Now it gives a much better opportunity to convert on third down.
Third and short yardage. Rivers. And this is complete. It's Allen. And he's in for a Charger touchdown. Keenan Allen, his second touchdown of the afternoon. The Chargers, they're able to widen their lead. They were still throwing with a comfortable lead here late, and now that lead even more comfortable.
And your first thought is it bad blood that went into this one ahead of time, that maybe they're seeking some revenge or they just don't like them? But the other thing that always hits me is, are they worried about playoff positioning? Right? Are they worried about, do you need enough points in case there's a tiebreaker that comes into play later?
Badgley on for the extra point. And the lead now to 3 touchdowns at 21 points. A 10-play drive that time. And it ends with the Chargers getting into the end zone. The kickoff team on the field now as they will send this one away. That's fielded in the end zone. And no run back here. This will be a touchback, and it comes out to the 25-yard line. And the Rams getting set to go now.
And right now these guys, they're shuffling a little bit, maybe doubting, because 3 straight drives have ended with them punting the football away.
Yeah, so you start pointing fingers at each other a little bit, asking a lot of questions. What are you seeing? What are you getting? Maybe trying to narrow down your playbook a little bit and maybe get simpler rather than more complex in order to try and fashion together a drive.
Here's a throw, complete right side to start things out. No gain there on the completion, 2nd and 10.
Well, that was a simple throw and catch, but even with that completion, 0 yards gained, so they're behind schedule on down and distance.
I think they were hoping to get it to him. He could make a man or two miss, but that window closed quickly.
Had the completed pass, but for no gain, stopped right at the line, so it's 2nd and 10. Goff now to throw. Looking to set for Woods, and it's intercepted. Picked off by Adrian Phillips. And he is going to bring this back inside the 20 to the 18-yard line. Woods, the intended receiver.
Well, this defensive pressure has been constant all game long. The pass rush, the coverage, they've all been excellent. And now they'll tack on an interception here as this one continues to slip just further and further out of hand.
So out come the Chargers, and they'll be looking to build off of a nice drive last time, a drive that really relied on the quarterback.
making good decisions, distributing the ball well, distributing it accurately, keeping it away from danger. A really nicely run drive.
But now the defense, what adjustments do they need to make in the passing game?
Pass rush, pass rush, pass rush. There's the guys up front, or maybe you bring additional guys, but you've got to disrupt the timing of them throwing the football.
We'll see if they can disrupt it here. Corey Littleton there on the tackle.
But they certainly got dented with that first down run. So now they've got to be back on their heels a little bit as a defense.
Get to 180! 190! Come on!
Hey, let's get that home!
To throw on second and six, Rivers. He'll get this to Eckler. And now they're inside the 10 as he's brought down at the 9. 5 yards on the pickup, and that is going to set up a third and one. And at his size, he's a smaller back. You can get him to football. He can kind of get lost, make someone miss. It's good for him.
Yeah, it's great for him. I like what you said there. Sometimes he gets lost in the traffic a little bit, but get him out in the open field into some space. That plays to his strengths the best and keeps him out of it where all the big boys are, you know, make him make someone miss in the open field.
Give him a gain of 4, able to convert, and that sets up first and goal now. He's been the go-to guy. They needed a big play there on third down. Went his way, it worked out.
Doesn't matter whether they've scouted it or that they think he's going to get the ball. He has a knack for finding his way open and completing the connection.
They come out here in the eye. First and goal, Melvin Gordon. And he is into the end zone. Touchdown, Los Angeles. Melvin Gordon with his second touchdown of the afternoon. And the Chargers capitalize on the short field as they take it in for 6. And he certainly played a pivotal role with those 2 TDs and why they're up on the scoreboard right now.
Well, someone's all about winning, aren't they? Because he's not worried about the number. Sure, it's great to have 2 touchdowns. But the bottom line is what he's doing is contributing to their lead. He wants to continue to do so.
Here's Badgley now to try to add the PAT. And he's been a busy man, 5 for 5 now as he knocks another one through to extend the lead. So that drive, 4 plays, and it's capped off by a touchdown run coming from Melvin Gordon. Out is the kickoff unit as they run up and send this one away. This will be taken to the back of the end zone. And no run back here. This will be a touchback, and it comes out to the 25-yard line. Jared Goff and the Rams headed back onto the field. And that interception that ended their previous drive likely also ended any shot they had at victory.
Yeah, long road back from here, no doubt about that one. But let's face it, if you're going to go out there and compete, you want to try and end on a strong note, don't you?
Absolutely. It won't end in a victory, like you said, but they can maybe take something positive out of this one. And they'll get it all the way up about 5 yards shy of midfield. An ideal beginning of the drive there as they'll get 20 and a first down. Hard to believe his first catch of the game defensively. They bottled him up. That's why they're well on their way to victory.
Put your best cover guy on him and then change the coverages behind him throughout the game. Brackets, double, zone, man, you name it. Make sure he gets a lot of angles.
The big play to start him out. Has him at the 45 already.
Hey, we got 4. We got 4 now.
There's Goff. He gets it to Cooks. Give him 9 there on the first down completion.
Complete.
That last catch short of the marker by just a yard leaves him with a very manageable second and one. Delayed give, Goff to Gurley. And he'll be brought down at the 45-yard line. 2 yards, good enough for a first.
Second and one, and people want to run the football. This is where every back in the league is supposed to do exactly what we just saw there. Pick up the first down.
Black 20.
Hey, I'm coming after you. I'm coming after you.
58, right over there, right over there. Yeah.
On first and 10, Goff. Pass incomplete. Another incompletion. You know, it's a wonder he's still moving around back there the number of times he's been sacked.
Yeah, he's staying out there, isn't he? And you don't think about it much in a game like this, but he's showing incredible leadership. Still competing, still fighting, not taking himself out of a ball game that appears lost.
So after the incompletion on first, now second and 10. Now Goff. He'll throw underneath for Gurley. And the stop here will come at the 38-yard line. It's a gain of 7, and just like that, it's third down. You got the big lead defensively, willing to give them that underneath stuff, right?
And this is why you work on your tackling. Tackle them after the catch, inbounds, keep the clock running. Just go ahead and bleed the game out that way.
31's the mic.
They'll try and pick up the first with Gurley. And boy, he is very close to a first down, but from where they're spotting that football, he's going to be a foot or so short. The ball still a few inches shy of the marker after the 3-yard run, so now a little soul searching on fourth down. This late in the game, Charles, I think you maybe seriously have to think about going for it.
Especially where they are in terms of field position, because this is almost like no man's land. Might hurt your punter because there might not be enough space, maybe too far for your field goal kicker. I'm like the old rule. Possession is 9/10 of the law. Possession is 9/10 of winning the game. Go for it. Get the first down. Close it out.
And he gets it to the 32. Good enough for a first down. No reason not to try it there, and they do indeed convert on fourth. Felt compelled to go for it there on fourth down, trailing in the fourth quarter. They got it done.
And there's always a lot of pressure on a fourth down call. Doesn't matter the distance. You still have to get it done, as you noted, and they did.
Now a draw play for Gurley. And maybe a measure of revenge there. He's had his way in this one, but this time they get him behind the line. He'll wind up losing a yard on the play, and it'll be second and 11.
Well, Brandon, he's had a great day, but sometimes the other guys make a play against you. What's that expression they like to use in the NFL? Those guys get paid, too, you know.
Yeah, in college they say, hey, they're on scholarship, too, in the NFL. They're getting paid, too. With the day he's had, you can have one go in the wrong direction. Maybe just a slight detour on what's been a strong drive. Here's second and 11. This is Brown on the draw play. And this one also slow in developing as he's maybe getting back here to the line of scrimmage, but not much more than that. Nice job there defensively to clamp down because really they've been on their heels this drive.
Agreed, and they really needed that one for confidence, just to feel a little bit better. But I don't know if I would be daunted by them stopping me on one run. This drive has gone pretty well. I could come right back at them.
And they'll set up the screen to Gurley. And he'll be stopped at the 27-yard line, well short of the first down marker. The screen good for 6, but it's not enough as it leads to a fourth down. One thing I think that's safe to say defensively, the tackling's been really good.
And because of that, it's been very, very hard for them to move the ball because you're not getting the benefits of run after catch. They're tackling them almost on the spot. That means they have to run extra plays, harder to move it.
So now here comes the field goal team for the third time today. This from 44 yards out, left hash. Zerline's kick is up and through. And the drive will wind up yielding 3. Well, in the grand scheme of things, those 3 points likely not going to matter much, but I guess they get a little closer, a little more respectability.
Yeah, you're exactly right. They've been outplayed all game long, but like my mom used to tell me all the time before I went out, dress up a little bit, son. Make yourself respectable. And that's what they're doing here. They're just dressing up the final score.
After the main field goal, Zuerlein back out there now to send this one away. This is taken at his four. And he'll take this across the 25, a couple extra yards, up to the 27-yard line. The Charger offense making their way back out there. The outcome of this one, well, we know who's going to win it. It's just all window dressing at this point. Got me thinking, what's the biggest blowout that you've been a part of as a player, broadcaster?
No, I'm not going to go to the player part because when I think blowout...
Because you won every game as a player.
No. I think about being blown out. And no one wants to go back to those memories. But, you know, when I was calling college football, I saw a game that... You know, a team put 70. I actually saw it happen twice. A team put 70 on their opponent. And in the NFL in the 2017 season, I saw one of those changing of the guard games where a team that hadn't been very good before now was dominating and kicking around a team who had been ruling their division.
And that's when you earn your paycheck, right? As the analyst, you got to fill that time.
You've got to know what's going on out there and how it all happened.
Well, obviously, that begs the question. What game was it?
That was Seattle hosting Los Angeles, the Rams.
Ah, yeah.
Their second meeting of the season, and the Rams turned it around from the first one and blew out the Seahawks.
Wait, 89!
Play fake to Gordon. Now Rivers. And it's complete. Henry. And he's able to get this to the 40-yard line before he's out of bounds. That one goes for 24 yards. They have the nice cushion. They just want to pour it on right now, still throwing the football.
And I know my background says, why do you need to do this? Just go ahead and run out the clock and get a win. But as many people pointed out to me, this is a video game, man. Go ahead and put the numbers up. Sportsmanship, not an issue.
Exercise those fingers. So from Rams territory now, it's first and 10, right at the 40. Rivers going to turn and give this one to his running back, Gordon. And he'll lose yardage here, back at the 41. It's a loss of a yard there, and now second down.
Brandon, it's clearly a running situation when you're up in the fourth quarter. They're going to have to stack the box and make it difficult for them to move the ball.
Made it very difficult right there. Now they need to repeat that effort.
Yeah, bring 7, 8, 9, whatever it's going to take to slow them down.
Set, 390.
Tight end, let's go right here now. Tight end right.
Now a fake on the give here as they try the run pass option. Now a hit, and Rivers lost the football. And now the Rams have got it, going the other way. And they'll start out with great field position at the 47-yard line in enemy territory.
All right, partner, this is where I get to show my age. Because I remember when the strip sack kind of came into vogue, where defenders were taught not just to make the tackle, but do that little extra, try and jostle the arm of the runner and knock it free. And that's what we just saw there.
Todd Gurley and the Rams offense set to take over. And there are the numbers. Got off to that torrid hot start. We thought he was in for maybe a career day. Not the case.
No doubt about it. It almost looks like a misprint after what we saw in the first half. But let's give a little bit of credit to the guys on our side of the ball. They came in at halftime, made a few adjustments. And you know what else? They didn't lose their confidence in their ability to play. Because a lot of times you get beat down in the first half, it gets ugly in the second half. They've come out with a new resolve and a renewed determination. I think it's okay there. They didn't get a whole lot on that play, but it's nice to have a safety valve that's built like this guy. Big target, guy you can spot pretty easily. Put it on him when your other targets aren't open.
That first down completion only netted him 3. Second and 7. Now Goff will hand this one to Gurley. And able to push forward for right around 3 yards down to the 42. The Rams on third down. They've been stymied left and right, converted only 1 time. This will be 3rd and 5. Goff. This is caught. It's Cooks. And he's going to get this down near the 30-yard line. It's a gain of 11 and a first down, L.A.
Never make the mistake that the slot receivers, especially the little guys like we're watching here, are just quicker than fast. A lot of them combine quickness and speed, and they catch a lot of footballs, as we just saw there.
So first and 10 now from the 30.
Back to you. I'm going back to you.
A shotgun snap for Goff. That's complete to his tight end Higbee. It's a gain of 11 and a first down, L.A.
I got a kick out of that one, partner. You and I talk often about trying to hide receivers in certain situations, but a guy of his size can't really hide him. But the tight end drag route, definitely an effective way to sneak him across the formation for an easy completion and a first down.
On first down, it's Gurley. And able to fight forward inside the 15 to the 13. A solid run on first down. Gain of 7 leaves him with a 2nd and 3.
This drive is turning into an extended one, and the guy carrying the ball, he's becoming more like a body blows guy. Every carry is putting some damage on the defense. So after a while, I'm not too sure how many guys are going to want to run up and tackle him.
A good run, got 7 on first. Here's 2nd and 3.
31's the mic. Blue Dan, Blue Dan.
Running right, here's Brown. And they'll go backwards here, losing yardage to the 14. It'll go as a loss of a yard, and it'll set up 3rd down. What happened there? Was that just a missed assignment on the O-line?
It certainly felt like it, but also the speed of the play. When you talk about defensive end, they want to be ahead of the clock, don't they? They want to be upfield, making plays on every snap. How about his agility there to run that one down?
An extra cornerback now in the game for the Chargers here on third. Just 2 minutes remaining here in the 4th quarter of what has been a one-sided affair. So it's Rams football here as we get you reset. They face a 3rd down now as they try to find a late score. Here's Goff. Man open, it's Kupp. He's got it. The gain of 5 that time gives him the conversion and makes it 1st and goal.
And that's understanding where the markers are, because it's not just running to them. Because on the catch, you could actually be pushed back before the 1st down. He's getting past it and allowing that opportunity to drift back towards the 1st down line and still having picked it up. Really well run.
Black 20.
Mike 58, right there.
From the gun, here's Goff. And they're going to get him. They bring him down to the sack back at the 16-yard line. The former 3rd-round pick, Justin Jones, bringing the lumber that time.
Well, there's still time to rectify this situation, because the silver lining, it took a sack on 1st and goal. But that close to the goal line, that still definitely hurts.
Now they got to get to the line quickly. After the sack on 1st down, Goff. And he's got it. That's Kupp for a Ram touchdown. Cooper Kupp there to make the grab. And the Rams are able to draw a bit closer.
Well, that's what I call an answer right there. They gave up a sack on the previous play. How about what they did to finish things off, turning it right back around?
That's the response, and that O-line feels a lot better now, don't they?
Yeah, without a doubt, because give up the sack on the previous play, that just hurts those guys, because they never want to see their guy get hit.
And there's going to be a stoppage here. The booth wants to take another look at this potential touchdown. It took them an extra look, but they found out it is a touchdown indeed. The official says this one counts. Zuerlein good with a PAT, and that will shave one more off this lead.
So that drive consumes 9 plays all told. And the result for the Rams, a touchdown. So it would no doubt be a miracle comeback from here, but let's see what they can do starting with the onside kick. And this will not work out. The Chargers able to recover. Well, fourth quarter, they felt like they needed the football back. Unfortunately, they couldn't get it.
And I know we brought analytics into the game, and someone has said here that the data says that when a team's expecting an onside kick, 80% of the time, the team expecting it, they do actually recover the ball, which is what we saw here. I just wonder if that number is much more of a anecdotal type of a number. Kind of like when the coaches tell us, well, when you score on special teams, 93% of the time you win the game. I'm still waiting to see that number is empirical.
They'll run on first down. Gordon. And this one goes nowhere. Losing yardage on the play back at the 46. It's a loss of a yard there, and it's second down.
This offense has had a lot to like in this game. I don't know that that last play, though, is going to make the highlight reel.
It's not going to make the highlight reel, but it will be the focus of the film session that the team has to sit through. I've sat through those before. Never any fun. You're always excited about your good plays, and they actually fast forward through those. All right, that was good. All right, great. They get to the bad ones and really illuminate them. Not cool.
They keep it on the ground. Again, Gordon. 8 yards there on the carry, and now they're left with a much more manageable 3rd and 3.
That's a gain of 8. Makes it 3rd and 3.
Check the white 90. Round 80.
Well, Charles, it's one thing to win. It's another thing to win and put up the amount of points that they did. Boy, were they clicking on offense.
They can't help but feel great about themselves, can they? I mean, what a game to put up that number of points, continually feeling like they're moving the ball and things are working and clicking. They think that they can bottle this and carry it with them.
And as an offensive coordinator, you just don't think you can do anything wrong. Whatever you call, run, pass, it's all going to work.
That's called being in the zone.
So that'll do it for us. For Charles Davis and all our crew, I'm Brandon Gauden. You've been watching the NFL on EA Sports. From Southern California, so long, everybody.